Christmas episode of Murder, She Said.
Leo is doing it tonight. Ted, now my Christmas wish for the season, just one thing. I know that our thing is to go around from town to town rocking and rolling and solving murders.
Yes, we do.
But I feel like this season I don't want to solve any murders. So that's my Christmas wish that I don't. So if any murders happen, call the authorities. Don't make me solve them.
Sure, I think that's a fine Christmas wish to have. I'm personally happy that I haven't been any murders as yet tonight. I don't like it when bad things happen to you good people, and murder would be one of the worst.
I agree with that, but mostly I just don't feel like solving murder, so, you know. So we're gonna play Christmas songs instead, and this first Christmas song is this bizarre little song that we found by Status Quo.
Underneath the mistletoe, it's Christmas.
you so much.
Thanks, Aimee.
And you know, Ted, everybody else, I really respect you not asking me to solve murders. Oh, really feels, that feels
sorry.
Good.
Hey, it's your gift guys. Jonathan Colton.
Yeah, hi.
Hi. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jonathan Colton. You're not due on stage
for a little while.
I'm not in the set yet, but there's been a murder.
Oh.
Well, you know what?
Sorry, folks. I guess that's...
No, Ted, I told you I was a song of murders. I don't care. We're singing the next song. Let's do like a holiday number. 2, 3, 4. This year the sleigh bells ringling, jing, jing, jingling too. Everybody, come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. No one wants to talk about a murder.
No, stop. What are you doing?
No one wants to deal with murder. It's Christmas. It's not murder time.
I understand that, but we have a job to do. As you mentioned earlier, this is what we do. We travel around the world rocking and rolling and solving murders. This happened on our patch. I think we need to solve it.
Look, call the homicide detectives. That's their job. Like, did you call the police?
I didn't call the police because I thought I should check in with you guys first because of your crime-solving show.
Thank you.
Look, I think we should call the proper authorities. Someone backstage can probably do that. Second of all, it's obvious that it was someone backstage.
Wait a minute.
I mean,
a lot of people
had access.
Don't you even want to know what happened?
Let me ask a question. Do you recognize this hat?
Yeah, I'm familiar with that hat.
Yeah, okay. You got me.
Do you know whose hat this was?
Could be any one of any number of Santa.
Yeah, could be a lot of different...
No, it's the backstage Santa.
Oh, my.
Well, the backstage Santa who's been touring with you guys.
That is really unfortunate. Look, I appreciate you coming out and telling me this, but I feel like we should stick to our plan. You know, if you call a homicide, tell them that in my opinion, it's probably somebody backstage, and then let them solve it. But thank you, Jonathan. We'll see you later.
All right.
Really sorry to sully this holiday with this information, but. But Ted and I have written a Christmas song. It is a little melancholy, but I feel like I would like to press forward and play this one.
Well, I go forward under protest from this point, but I go forward nonetheless.
Appreciate you. I appreciate you, Justin. Appreciate you as a person.
Thanks very much.
So this song is a song that we did write together. It's called Nothing Left to Do.
Thank you for cheering for our very new Christmas song. Two or three people who have heard it.
There's nothing left to do.
There's nothing left to do. Sleigh bells ring.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. A lot of special guests tonight. Let's bring our first guest out, Ms. Susanna Hoffs, to the stage, please.
Actually, Jonathan, I prefer the full Jonathan.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. We've discussed this a million times, Mom.
Rock.
Okay. So here's the thing. You know, I agreed to do this Christmas show thing with Aimee and Ted because, frankly, the money is fantastic. But I have a confession to make, which is that I'm not a huge fan of Christmas music in general. I know. Maybe I'm a bad guy. But I feel like one of the worst Christmas songs is a song called Jingle Bell Rock. Because what is it? What are they even talking about? there's apparently there's a jingle hop going on at Jingle Bell Square. What is a jingle hop? Everybody's wearing bells and dancing around? That sounds terrible. It's basically they just put all the words about Christmas into a bag, shook it up, and dumped that out on a table. And that's the song. So I'm gonna do that song for you now. But because I don't want to expend a lot of energy doing it, I'm going to use this computer device. It's just going to make it a little easier for me, as I think you will see. So, Merry Christmas. Loves it. Every year it comes around, everybody's like, oh, remember this one? The thing is, I have written Christmas songs. This is a Christmas song that I wrote. It was supposed to be sort of just a funny mashup of various Christmas memes, just all jumbled together in a hilarious way. But I think I may have been secretly writing about my parents' divorce or something. Because it came out kind of sad and weird. So, I'm going to do that one for you now. This is called Christmas is Interesting. You have put on your feet.
pajamas. It's time for a long winter's nap. There's a knock on the door and a stranger is there. He wants you to sit on his lap. He takes your watch and he gives you a hairbrush. Wife gets a wig on a chain. He says he can't stay, cause he's got a long way to go and it's starting to rain. Christmas is interesting, like a knife in your heart. Christmas is interesting, how it tears you apart. Christmas is interesting, like a stick in your eye. So freaking interesting that it might make you cry. So you're an elf, but you'd rather be a dentist. Maybe you're a train with square wheels. Maybe you're a squirt gun that only shoots jam. Now you know how Jesus feels. He's riding a sleigh he calls Rosebud. His mansion is lonely and cold. He can't remember a pleasant December. He wasn't tired and old. Christmas is interesting, like a knife in your heart. Christmas is interesting, how it tears you apart. Christmas is interesting, like a stick in your eye. So freaking interesting that it might make you cry. So you're drunk, your name is Jimmy Stewart. Once had a wonderful life. You lost all your money, you cracked up your car, you yelled at your favorite wife. Go to bed and you wait for Jacob Marley. He comes to make you feel brave. But under his cloak he is nothing but smoke and a finger that points at your grave.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Christmas is interesting, like a knife in your heart. Christmas is interesting, how it tears you apart. Christmas is interesting, like a stick in your eye. So freaking interesting that it might make you cry.
Thank you. Some help from the band on this one. This is going to be exciting, everybody. We're going to do a little sing-along. Are you ready for a little sing-along? Okay. This one is not about Christmas at all. I think we've seen how that goes. This is a song about zombies. Weird applause line, but all right. I'm going to sing the part for you so that you know how it goes, and then we'll try it all together, okay? It's very short and very easy. Here's how it goes.
All we want to do is eat your brains.
That's it. All right? You've learned it? Let's try it all together. I should have said, I do that chord on the guitar and then I stop and then we sing. You're very enthusiastic and eager though, I love it. Wait for me, I'll cue you.
Go! All we want to do is eat.
That's the most anemic group of zombies I've ever heard. I know you can do better than that. I also want to remind you that as zombies, you should focus less on singing and more on being scary. If you've ever heard zombies sing, they are not particularly good at it. Nobody knows why. You know, a lot of them have had their mouths and throats and tongue parts destroyed by other zombies, or, you know, they're rotting from the inside. Who knows? They also are a very distracted bunch, zombies. They don't know how to really focus on a task or work together as a group. They start early, they finish late. And if you don't feel like singing, that's okay, neither do I. You could just make zombie noises and that would be fine, but it should be really loud and terrible, a cacophony, if you will. Okay? Let's try it again. Okay. Yeah, that's great. That's nearly unrecognizable. That's perfect. This is an office memo. This is an inter-office memo from a zombie to a human. They used to work together. It's complicated. Hey, Tom, it's Bob from the office down the hall. Good to see you, buddy. How've you been? Things have been okay for me, except that I'm a zombie now. I really wish you'd let us in. I think I speak for all of us when I say I understand why you folks might hesitate to submit to our demands. Here's an FYI, get ready, you're all gonna die.
Take it.
constructive criticism well. Thank you for your time. I know we're all busy as hell. And we'll put this thing to bed.
What are you doing now?
Synthetic rash.
I somehow have a lot of that cheap beard hair all over my top hat, and I didn't even touch it to your beard.
You just pronounced it top hat.
My top hat. That's
I feel like the emphasis is wrong. It's like rubber band.
Rubber band. Yeah, you're right. Plastic.
Sir, completely different linguistic topic.
I should have said,
paper towel.
You did your time in Boston, right?
I did my time.
You did your time.
You know what, on a date like today? You know how sometimes, like, when you have, like, an ex, and you're gonna see your ex, and you dress up, and, like, you're like, I want that ex to be really sorry, and I'm gonna look my best. I'm going to wear my best outfit and do my hair so that the ex feels really... Boston is not fucking doing that at all for me. Boston's like, I don't give a shit that you left me. Fuck you. How about a wintry mix?
And yet you probably would have understood me better if I'd said top hat. Man.
Keep doing it.
Hearing Susanna play Eternal Flame brings back a lot of Christmas memories.
Me too. Oh, me too, Ted Leo.
Yeah.
Me too. What kind of memories does it bring back?
Well, for example, surely you remember one of our most interesting cases happened around this time of year.
are solving murder cases as we're going around the country rocking and rolling and solving murders.
The world. Maybe you remember the case of the Colombian candy cane.
I did. You know, one of our more interesting cases for me was the Hanukkah arsonist who set 8 buildings on fire.
It was a tough one to crack. But we did it. We did it together. I don't know if you remember, but one of the most challenging for me as plucky sidekick was the case of the Advent Killender. Right? Those were good times we had, solving murders around Christmas.
I know what you're doing. You're trying to get me all nostalgic for murder solving, holiday murder solving. Yeah. That's not going to work. I'm all about the holiday songs. In fact, we're going to play a real classic now. None of these humorous holiday songs. Boy, that didn't go off. I don't have that weird tone to it that I didn't intend. This is I'll Be Home for Christmas.
Even more than I usually do. And although I know it's a long road back, I promise you I'll be home for Christmas. You can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree. Christmas Eve will find me where the love light gleams. I'll be home for Christmas.
That's my idea of like Christmas memories, and, you know, frosting home and presents under the tree and the lights and all that. Like you must have some classic Christmas song that puts you in the Christmas spirit.
It depends on your definition of the Christmas spirit. I have a lot of them. They all carry a hint of a, I don't know.
You got some baggage?
Yeah, they all carry some Christmas baggage, yeah. Every Christmas present carries some baggage with it for me. I will tell you that, like many, my family had our kind of go-to albums. being of a certain age, those were things like the Partridge Family Christmas, the Ventures Christmas album.
The Ventures. That's so fun Christmas.
No, that's a great one. It's just all guitar. In fact, I'm having a revelation right now. The Ventures Christmas album probably formed me.
So your style can be summed up in the Ventures Christmas album.
In more ways than I ever met. But we also had, you know, we had a classic, you know, some kind of compilation. I don't think it was K-Tel. It might have been actually like a Sears, you know, or something.
K-Tel.
Yeah. And it had classics on it, like Home for the Holidays and Christmas is Coming, the Goose is Getting Fat, Please Put a Penny in the Old Man's Hat. If you haven't got a penny, halfpenny will do. If you haven't got a halfpenny, then God bless you. But also sandwiched in there was a song that, from the very first notes, which I think it's like an oboe. It's an oboe, right?
Oh, I don't know. Okay.
Jimmy's my go-to guy for that.
Went to him and it came up empty.
It stuck to him. We'll say it's an oboe. From the very first strains or toots, you know, whatever it is an oboe does, I would notice that my father would disappear, and he would either go like out of the room or into a corner, and I would find him crying. And
so this must be some real moving.
Well,
lovely, beautiful, like Silent Night or Little Town of Bethlehem, like one of those real moving, ancient classics.
You know,
really.
If it had been, perhaps, you know, I would have been as moved as my father. But let me add this fact to the story. My three younger siblings, you know, we all noticed this around the same time. And remember, there were four of us. So all four of us then started just, you know, at the most inopportune times throughout the day, plop the needle on that song. Tortured the poor man.
Yeah, okay, so just throughout the day, you were like, let's make Dad cry.
Yeah. And that was hilarious to us.
Because you're a monster.
Yeah, absolutely. So maybe I can sing it for you both as a sort of, you know,
I'd be delighted.
As an amends and public penance.
I'm gonna burst into tears, I'm sure.
Also because it's not quite the classic tearjerker that you would imagine it would be. It's kind of melodramatic and schmaltzy, which fits the spirit of this show. And then, you know, thirdly, as an actual tribute to a genuinely, you know, sweet guy who could be so moved by a song like this, I give you the Ballad of the Christmas Donkey. Sounds like a joke. On Christmas morning, another day, a donkey cried in his donkey way. I'm not beautiful, I'm not beautiful, what good to anyone am I? Other animals are big and strong, or rare, or filled with an animal song. But I'm not beautiful, I'm not beautiful, what good to anyone am I? Heaven cried, donkey, you can carry, will you carry Mary? Angels for your guide. Now on Christmas morning, the stable hay, a donkey smiled in his donkey way. I feel beautiful, I feel beautiful as anyone am I. As beautiful as anyone.
Thank you very much. Too much Christmas joviality, so they brought the guy with depressing songs out. Speaking of melodramatic and schmaltzy, this is a Buffalo Tom song that mentions Christmas. Empty drawers, nothing left for me. But we turned around now, and what did we see? Just all our whispers and transparency. You're so
you're so green, you're like to invite Ted Leo to come up to your house. I opened up for Ted at a show at Brent Music Hall a few years back, probably five at this point. And he didn't tell me, but then all of a sudden he's playing a song. I'm like, that sounds familiar. And it was a song from my band. And so I said, would he be okay with me coming up and singing with him on this one? He was okay with it, so we're going to do that one.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bill.
Love that.
Good work, Susanna. Back. So So this is a total change of pace, because one of the things that I remember as a kid most about Christmas is singing in the choir in school, and this is one of the songs that we sang, and I always thought it was really pretty. So we're going to attempt to do a little choir thing. This is when you realize like how you, what a shitty singer you really are. In my case, anyway.
Me too.
But hopefully, with a bunch of us together, you won't be able to pick out who the bad one is.
It's me.
Susanna is Jewish. Maybe she could tell us about her Hanukkah traditions, or maybe tell some of the Hanukkah stories.
It's one of my favorite stories. I've studied it in depth, and I would love to hear your sort of, you know.
You know what I would like?
Your holiday take on.
I would like to hear it in song. I don't think that's actually too much. Some would say even nerdy on one side of the stage.
I don't know who would say that or why.
I never knew there was such a thing as a Hanukkah nerd, but now I know. I would like to bring back to the stage Mr. Jonathan Colton.
All their windows were dark. No one knew he was there.
All the hooves were all dreaming sweet dreams without care.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole. Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole.
All I need is a reindeer. So he took his dog Max, and he took some black thread, and he tied a big horn on the top of his head. Then the Grinch said, "Giddy up!" And the sleigh started down to the homes where the Whos lay a snooze in their town. This is stop number one. The old Grinchy Claus hissed as he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pinch. But if Santa could do it, then so could the Grinch. Then he slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room, and he took every present. Popguns, pantoufles, pantoufles, and drums. Checkerboards, bizzlebuns, popcorn, and plums. And he stuffed them in bags. Then the Grinch very nimbly stuffed all the bags, one by one, up the chimney.
You're a foul one, Mr. Grinch. You're a nasty, wasty scum. Your heart is full of unwashed sex. Your soul is full of gum, Mr. Grinch.
The three words that best describe you are as follows, and I quote, stink, stank, stunk.
Nauseate me, Mr. Grinch, with a nauseous silver nose.
You're a crooked, jerky jockey, and you drive a crooked horse, Mr. Grinch. You're a three-decker sauerkraut and toadstool sandwich with arsenic sauce.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Some people maybe work down by the lawn on D or something.
That was the first one in New
John's in New England? Wow.
It's the flagship John's.
Flagship John's. I'm going to tell you, can I tell you a really quick story while
sure.
we're intro? Many, many years ago, I, with my band, with which we play under my own name, were on a tour and...
His name is Ted.
We were playing at the University of Wisconsin Whitewater. It's in Whitewater, Wisconsin. Did you go to the University of Wisconsin? You're fancy. Anyway.
They like water.
It was a little bit out of our way between two shows, but the guy who had asked us to come play on his radio show was like, man, listen, I promise. Come by, I'll feed you. That was all we needed to hear, really. Yes.
Yeah.
And then he kept talking up this sandwich shop. He kept being like, look, I'm telling you, the best sandwich shop in the world is in Whitewater. Yeah. Like, I'm vegan, so for me, I was just like, well, you know, I'll have the same thing I always have. Salad on a...
Portobello mushroom sandwich?
Yeah, no, that, well, not even. This is another discussion. But, you know...
You have two pieces of bread, yeah, basically. That's
everybody else is very excited, and we played the show, and then he was like, ready for sandwiches.
Yeah.
And he took us to a Jimmy John's.
Best sandwich shop in Wisconsin.
Now featured in the Lawn on D.
No, we know it. All right, I have no idea where we are now. We're going to play a song of Mr. Ted Leo and a song of mine. It's one of my favorite songs of Ted's.
That's
why I insisted that we play it.
There was a Christmas tree that I made sure it's for. Halloween was just to the Christmas, and he's the fans all small.
Thank you. favorite songs of yours. It's one of my favorite songs of all time.
Ted Leo, I feel like you like the song so much it's making you sweat. You have to mop your face.
Still left over, that's a move I forgot to bust out in the donkey song.
Well, this song is not Christmassy at all.
really sorry to step on the tail of such a beautiful song with this kind of news, but I've gotten a flurry of texts from backstage, and apparently it's getting very uncomfortable with a rotting corpse belching out for justice in the cramped dressing room.
Ted, I feel like I made this very clear. I believe the homicide division is on it. It's not my problem, and this is what we do. We look at our set list, we look at what the next song is, and then we play that song for the people.
We've handled a lot of the set list. I feel like...
What does it say? Read the set list. What does it say? Does it say solve the murder? If it says solve the murder, I'll solve the murder.
It doesn't say solve.
Yeah, I didn't think so. What does it say?
It says Baby It's Cold Outside.
Baby It's Cold Outside? That's right. It's a song we're going to sing next. Hit it, fellas.
Hit it, fellas.
I gotta get tough. I gotta get tough with you. I've got to go away.
Aimee, there's been a murder backstage.
This evening has been.
I'm hoping that rigor hasn't set
so very nice.
By now, Santa's corpse is cold as ice.
Ted, you know my position.
But everyone back there's under suspicion.
So don't you go and ruin.
One of them are strong.
Murder's not a Christmas tree.
But solving murders is part of our mission.
So why don't you just split up?
The audience knows right from
wrong.
I just think it's time.
I'm gonna stop to this.
We got to solving this crime.
So calling the cops for this.
No! This is why we need vigilantes like you.
I know.
And your brilliant mind.
It's true, I am one
yes.
of a kind.
Think of all the glorious headlines.
Tapes was probably close to the deadline.
Your picture on every front page.
Something we all now starts to end.
We gotta keep the crowd safe.
People probably don't know this, but we have a chord that we play, a suspect, and generally that encourages honesty, and it often brings out a confession, the chord being, of course,
C major.
But Ted, I feel like in this circumstance, it's a special circumstance because Christmas is kind of the season of lying. Like, there's so much lying that goes on, like, I wish goodwill towards men, and, I love that present that you got me, that kind of thing. So I feel like we need to bring out the big guns.
All right, what did you have in mind?
Well, we need a song, and it's got to be a song that relentlessly just beats the truth out of people so that they confess, like, whatever the worst thing they've ever done.
I think we know just the one.
Yeah, I think so.
Is Susanna Hoffs available? Can we get Susanna Hoffs out of here? Hi, Susanna. How you doing? How's it going backstage?
I just wanted to...
Are you going okay back there?
Yes.
Listen, if you wouldn't mind, we just want to ask a few things. Ask a few questions.
yourself.
I stole a Smurf special tour chocolate.
What?
And I said, yeah, and there's more. You told me not to play your guitar, but I did without your permission.
You touched my guitar?
I touched it. I played it.
Listen, this is not the confession we were looking for, but we'll deal with this later. Please step to the back of the stage, young lady.
Susanna Hoffs is so nice that the worst thing she's ever done is she stole a piece of chocolate and touched her guitar.
Yeah.
I mean, that's totally insignificant. You're really showing us up here.
Let's get, let's see if you know who else has been backstage all night. Mr. Bill Janet.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Get him up here.
Let's get him up here.
Play cool.
Let's get him up here.
Play cool. We can't know what we're up to.
Hey, Bill, how's it going?
Hey, Bill.
Thanks so much for joining us today.
We wanted to thank you.
Really appreciate it.
Playing the show was really, really, really nice. It's like very nice.
Listen, we just wanted to tell you.
We're simply having a wonderful Christmas time.
Church,
man.
I do have a confession, but I don't think this is either the time or the place.
No, it's exactly the time and the place.
But it's Boston, and the confession is I was never a big fan of Till Tuesday.
Did he not let you sit on his lap? What was his...
No, I don't know. I guess we just got off on the wrong foot and then I bludgeoned him.
All right, well...
Great.
Thanks for confessing you did the right thing.
Okay.
And that's really all we need.
Yeah.
You know, Ted...
Yeah?
I feel like I've really come around on something tonight.
What's that, Aimee?
Maybe Christmas is all about solving murders, after all.
Indeed.
Christmas time is here, happiness and cheer, fun for all the children call their favorite time of year.
Feel free to sing along.
Snowflakes in the air, carols everywhere, olden time.
Jimmy Kendall of Jim Keyboards. Ted Mayhall Paul on drums. Fabulous Paul running on bass. And all our special guests, Susanna Hoffs.
Christmas.